Hey, welcome back. In this video, I've got an example where someone is dropping an object off of a cliff. They're dropping it from a height of 25 meters above the ground that it's going to impact. And we want to figure out how long does this object fall for before it hits the ground, and what is the final velocity, or basically like the impact velocity, right at the moment before it hits the ground. So to get started with problems like this, I recommend always writing down your initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, time, and distance traveled. So the initial velocity is going to be 0 meters per second. Basically, this person is just letting it go, releasing it from arrest. So 0 meters per second. We're looking for the final velocity at impact. We don't know that value yet. Acceleration is going to be negative 9.81 meters per second squared. And we're saying negative because we consider the up direction to be the positive y direction. In acceleration, it's accelerating downwards, which is an opposite to the positive direction. So that's going to be negative. Time, again, we don't know what the time is, we're looking for that. And the distance traveled is going to be negative 25 meters because it's moving opposite to what we consider positive, and it's going 25 meters. So we have negative 25 meters in acceleration that is meters per second squared. All right, so if you have the kinematic equations written down somewhere, you basically want to bring those up. If you don't have them, if you're on a test or something and you have to come up with them, like I said in previous videos, I've got videos that go over how to derive these, but typically you're giving these on a formula sheet. So whatever your situation is, if you have to derive them or if you have to look them up, but basically all you have to do is just figure out which equation you need to use. Each of these equations is pretty much just going to be missing one of these variables, and so you'll be able to just use the one unknown in one equation to figure out what you're looking for. In this case, to solve for the time first, it's going to be this one here, s is equal to vit plus 1/2 at squared. Because we have s, we have vi, we're missing t, and we have a here again, and we're missing t again. So there's really only one unknown here. So let's write that out. And when we fill in our values here, s was negative 25 meters, vi is 0, and times t, so this whole term is going to go to 0. And then we have plus 1/2 times negative 9.81, that's meters per second squared, times time squared. All right, so negative 9.81 times 1/2 is negative 4.905. We're going to bring that down into the denominator on the other side. So we have 25 meters over negative 4.905 meters per second squared. And that is all equal to t squared. So if we just simplify the left-hand side, we have 5.097 seconds squared is equal to t squared. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take the square root of both sides now. And we're gonna find that t is equal to, well, really it's plus or minus 2.26 seconds, but it's time, so we can discard the negative value. So we have t is equal to 2.26 seconds. So that's how long it takes for when this person releases this object until it hits the ground. All right, now the other part of this question was we wanted to figure out what the final velocity is, basically the velocity right at the point of impact. We have everything else now, so we can just pick which formula we want to use. This one here, A equals VF minus VIT, is basically going to be the one we're looking for, which is also the same thing. If you look here and you look at this one, if you just rearrange one of these, you can get the other one. These are basically the exact same equation. So I have them both written down here because there's different approaches to get both of these, but or sometimes you'll see one or the other, but essentially they are the same expression. All right, so let's just pick this one here. We have A is equal to VF minus VI over T. So we have negative 9.81 meters per second squared is equal to VF minus VI was 0 and T was 2.26 seconds. So basically just multiply both sides by 2.26. We have negative 2.26 seconds. That gives us units of meters per second on the left hand side, and that is equal to VF. And again, it's negative because velocity indicates direction as well. It's a magnitude and a direction. Negative is going opposite our positive sign here, so it indicates that it is going down and the magnitude is 22.17 meters per second. So there we go. We found the time it takes for it to hit the ground and the impact velocity.